interest in creating this project, bringing together the Kennedy Center and the National Institutes of Health, was in amplifying the breadth of the work in research, in childhood development, certainly in therapies. I noticed research coming out about the fact that music has been discovered to be in a lot of parts of the brain, and therefore it engages so much of us. I felt instinctively that not enough people knew about this work. And I also felt that it helps music and the arts maintain a place in society that they really should have.
So, what was it like for you in that brain scanner?
Well, you know, it's an incredible challenge because you're not supposed to move. And it was 2 hours. I was in the machine for 2 hours.
I offered myself as a guinea pig in this fMRI experiment on music, and the test was devised to try and understand how music affects the brain in different ways. So they had me singing, imagining singing, and speaking. I chose something that I thought I could sing 13 times comfortably, and I also chose something that I thought I could have an emotional connection to in an MRI, and it was The Water Is Wide. Result, when you look at the pictures, is that different parts of the brain are engaged in all three cases. And surprisingly, imagining singing was the most powerful, had the most engagement. The actual singing piece was easier, but the imagining piece took more effort, a little bit more focus, more intention. There's musical elements, I think we will eventually understand, to have more power over us, whether it's melody, certain harmonies, harmonic tension. You know, why do we cry in certain music? Why does certain music lift us up, make us feel joy, or inspire us to action? There's a small amount of creativity and improvisation going on in performance because that's the art of interpretation. You know, how am I going to shape this line? How am I going to create a color that is particularly effective in this moment? Or, you know, how will I build the emotional content?